And good afternoon. Welcome to the News and Music Show for Friday, January 27th. It's a beautiful day out today. We kicked off today's show with a Canadian artist. Her name is Lynn Jackson from her CD Sweet Relief. We heard track number one, Gone for Good. After that, some information from our ocean world. And we're very fortunate to have a guest in the audience today. We're going to be interviewing Miguel, and he's going to be playing at Music Chez Nous tonight on the campus of Bishop's University in Bandine Hall, I believe. Is that correct?
Yeah, okay.
Okay, would you like to tell us a little bit about your background? You have quite a musical background.
Sure. Ever since I was born, I've been surrounded by music in a sort of way. But any professional artist was in the family. I think I'm the only crazy one to do it. And I started to play the guitar when I was 10 years old. And when I was improving on the electric guitar, I went to Germany to study under Olaf Siefers, one of the electric guitar virtuosos in the 90s. And after that, I decided to make a full degree in classical music in the conservatoire style. So I switched to classical guitar, and I studied with Chuy Posada. There's a world-class performer from Mexico. And after some years, I came to Bishop's as an exchange student to study under the guidance of Dr. Paul McDonald. And I'm here. I'm finished.
Okay, and you've concluded your musical degree. You also are the co-founder of UAC's Guitar Orchestra?
Yeah, that guitar orchestra was a very good project when it started as a dream to have like the best young performers of Mexico united in a guitar orchestra. And we did some great job at the time.
Right, so you're quite an accomplished young man for your age, especially. You've also won many prestigious competitions, first place in the category in the Sherbrooke Music Competition, as well as another competition. Is that correct, too?
There was another competition in Mexico, yeah.
Okay. He's going to be playing at the Bandine Hall. That's on the campus of Bishop's University. And that is tonight, January 27th at 8 p.m. And tickets are available. You can call 822-9600, or you can pick them up at the concert, just before the concert. It's only $15 for the general public and only $10 for students. So that's tonight.
Sorry, students are free.
Students are free. Oh, even better. So $15 for the general public, and students are free. So great classical music. And Miguel is going to give us a taste of that. Are you ready yet, or would you like a few minutes to?
Just to tune the guitar.
Okay, so we're just going to be back in a couple minutes. And before that, we're going to hear from Canadian artist Ricky Paquette. We're going to hear track number one from his seat early for the show. And that's called Caledonia. And Ricky Paquette was featured on Blues Deluxe last night. If you listened to the syndicated show last night, every Thursday from 8 to 9. So we're going to give a listen to that, come back, and we're back with Miguel here on the News and Music Show on CJMQ 88.9 FM. The time right now is 12:17. We just heard from Ricky Paquette, Canadian artist, a blues artist, quite young too, in fact, very talented. We heard from his CD early for the show, and track number one, Caledonia. And it is apparently the anniversary of Mozart's birth today, Miguel was telling me. So he has a few more words to say.
This concert is dedicated to the enduring memory of Mozart. Today is 250 years since he came to the world. This concert will be very, very special. It's a world event, actually, right now in Salzburg and German cities. They're having huge parties right now, celebrating Mozart. And tomorrow, actually, there's a big concert in Sherbrooke, too. So, Lennoxville will do its best right now, tonight, celebrating Mozart.
Oh, right, right. Interesting information there. Miguel was telling me he's also going to be playing the electric guitar, too, at the concert?
Yes. There is some pieces composed for the electric guitar. We're using the electric guitar in different techniques. You know, the rock techniques, heavy metal techniques, and also the Stanley Jordan technique. It's a very interesting and very rare, hard to find technique, because it involves like two guitars being played at the same time by one performer. So it's kind of like a piano style with the guitar. So the timbre is totally unique.
Okay, that sounds pretty interesting. Certainly well worth the going to the concert. And again, I'm going to say it is free for all students. And for the general public, it's only $15 on the campus of Bishop's University in the Bandine Hall tonight at 8 p.m. And would you like to give us a taste of your music live now?
Sure, I will be.
Okay, that's great.
Okay, this is some fragments from the Coyumbaba Suite by Carlo Domeniconi. Thank you.
That is just fantastic. Just blown away by the talent from a local musician here. He's going to be playing tonight at the Banding Hall, part of the Music Chaine New. It's free for students and only $15 for the public. Would you like to play another selection? Or?
Oh, yeah, sure. Yeah.
Okay, great.
To retune the guitar.
Okay, well, we're going to take a little break and hear another song from Ricky Paquette. Be back in. And we're back here in the booth on the News and Music Show. Just heard a word from our sponsors. Before that, we heard from Canadian blues musician Ricky Paquette from a CD early for the show. We heard track number 2, Crossroads. And we are back here with Quetzal Angelos. And he wants to let us know a few other details about the concert at Banding Hall tonight. Just one correction I need to make. If you're a senior citizen, it's $10, not $15. So it's $15 for the general public. If you're a senior citizen, it's $10, and it's free for all students. Okay, what did you would like to add?
I will be playing some Van Halen music and Yngwie Malmsteen, call him a Swedish virtuoso, on electric guitar. So I think will be very attractive for many people. From the society, not just the classical music lovers, but the rock lovers too, and some Mexican folk music too will be performed in this special Amadeus Mozart event. So I hope everyone enjoys it.
Oh, I'm sure they will. And again, this is partly to commemorate the birth of Mozart 250 years ago. Would you like to play another selection?
Yeah, sure. This is called Cuban Landscape with Bells by Cuban composer Leo Brower.
Okay. Thank you. And that was just a fantastic piece of music. I'm just blown away. How would you describe your music? It's classical, and yet it's also a bit of New Age too, isn't it?
Yeah, well, actually, the repertoire that I am right now performing, we could say is modern. It's classical, but it's modern. It's made in the, like a couple of years ago. Actually, this piece that I just performed, it was 1986.
Okay.
And the first one was made in 1985.
Mm-hmm.
So we can say it's contemporary classical music. So the principal point that the contemporary classical music has is that it embraces many, many different styles of folk and even rock music to incorporate these languages into the classical realm. So the classical composer can have more like a broad
wider range.
Yeah. So he could work with different timbres and techniques that popular music like rock or jazz can bring to the classical world.
Okay. That's, you know, fantastic. That was called Cuban Landscape?
Cuban Landscape with Bells.
With Bells, okay.
Yeah,
beautiful piece, yeah.
Thank you.
Again, he's Quetzal. Is going to be playing tonight, part of the Music Chez Nous in the Bandine Hall on the campus of Bishop's University. And this is a concert open to the public, students alike. It's free if you're a student. If you are a senior citizen, it's only $10 per ticket, and for the general public, only $15. Well worth going to, because it's not only for the classical music lover, it's for a lover of rock music too, and you even mentioned people interested in metal music too, because
there's a piece, an arrangement that a friend of mine did. It's called like the 80s, Rockin' Amadeus. So it will involve the electric guitar in the Malmsteen style, and with a synthesizer and a drum.
That sounds like quite a technique. How many hours do you practice a day or a week?
Good question. The average I could say is like 6 hours a day.
Six to eight hours,
because since I play the classical, but at the same time the electric. It's I have to switch a little bit because different techniques and different thinking how to approach the instrument. So pretty much you have to be living in music.
That's right. You're right. Your music is almost like your breath. It's, you know, synchronized with your breath, right? Okay. Would you like to play another selection? Or?
Sure.
Okay.
Yeah. I'm getting excited now.
Okay, great, and we're excited too. So don't miss out on this concert. It's tonight, the 27th of January, Bandine Hall, open to the public, free for all students, $10 senior citizens, and $15 for the general public. Okay, let's hear another tune. Okay, another great selection. What was that piece called?
That's The Spanish Fly.
The Spanish Fly?
Yeah, it's
okay.
Reminiscent to the flamenco style.
Right, right.
Yeah, mm-hmm. And it was composed by Edward Van Halen, a very famous rock musician, rock guitarist.
Okay.
He was very famous in the 80s because he developed mm-hmm. right, the tapping technique, is this technique like mm-hmm. playing on the fingerboard. And well, I think Van Halen is quite an influence.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah, Van Halen, yes. I know that many of our DJs are familiar with his work. Yeah. Okay, I didn't realize that he developed that technique. That's interesting. Okay.
Yes, very interesting.
Okay, so this marks the day of Mozart's birth, 250 years ago. Would you like to add anything else or play another selection?
I need to retune the guitar.
Okay, we're going to take a little break here and hear from a local artist, Lynn Hamilton. Just got the CD in yesterday from Townshippers. If you'd like what you hear, then go to Townshippers at 257 Queen Street in Lenoxville. It's in their Townships Expressions collection. The CD is called Let It Breathe, and we're going to hear track number one. And that was from Townshipper, Lynn Hamilton, from her new CD, Let It Breathe. We heard track number one, Ain't Misbehavin'. And we're back with Quetzal here. And if you haven't heard yet, he's playing live in the booth for us today. We're having that great opportunity. He's going to be playing at Bandine Hall tonight, part of the Music Shane News series. It's free if you're a student, so come on out and enjoy the evening. Starts at 8 o'clock. If you're a senior citizen, it's $10, and for the general public, only $15. And you prepared yet for another song?
Yes.
Okay, great. So let's hear another selection. Which one is this called?
Oh, this is Eto number one by Etrubia Lobos.
Okay. Okay, another great selection by Quetzal. Angelo's coming to the Music Shane New concert tonight at Bandine Hall. And they say that he's a classical guitar virtuoso, and that is certainly very true. I'd like to know how much Mozart has influenced your interest in music.
Oh, well, you know, in the 80s, the film Amadeus mm-hmm. was doing the very, very good. So I think pretty much it's thanks to this film that I started to enjoy more classical music. When I went to see it, I was I don't remember, like 6-year-old kid.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and it was a great impact on me. I wish I would be a better musician to understand Amadeus more fully, but I think he's a great influence on
us. Right.
Well.
Mm-hmm. And what about your parents? Did they influence you a lot in music too?
My parents more they kind of like they're always with me. They are not professional musicians or anything like that, but they enjoy music.
Right. So you have wonderful support from them. That's the most important thing. I just like to add that the concert tonight is entitled Echoes of Amadeus, and it's a very interesting concert, not just for those of you out there interested in classical music, but also in metal music, also in rock music, because some of the works are by featured works by Van Halen also, and as well as Mozart and some other people too. Okay, anything else you'd like to add?
No, I think I want to say thank you for this invitation here to your radio station, a great university. I'm enjoying it again a little bit.
Okay, well, it was our pleasure.
Memories.
Right. Are you planning on returning to Mexico soon?
Yeah, actually, I have to be in Ohio pretty soon for another recital there.
Okay, so, another recital.
I will be sad to leave again, but anyhow.
Well, we hope to see you back. I'm sure we will, because I'm sure you're going to have a fantastic career.
Well, we hope so. We don't know.
Oh, I can tell.
We'll
and Quetzal's going to bring us some music here at the CJMQ office next week. What we're going to do is put it on our rotation, and it's going to be our honor. Okay, so thank you very much for coming and spending some time with us. And get out tonight, everybody, and enjoy the concert. Remember, it is free for students, and it's a great way to spend the evening. Starts at 8 o'clock at the Banding Hall. And Quetzal was telling me that the Banding Hall has a great sound. If you're a senior citizen, it's only $10, and for the general public, it is a 15. So give the university a call. It's 822-9600, and they can direct you on directions how to get to the Banding Hall, or help you to reserve some tickets. Okay, well, thank you, and we're going to hear another selection from Townshipper Lynn Hamilton from her CD, Let It Breathe. We're going to hear track number 2, at least. Okay, and my time's almost finished. Stay tuned for a lot more good music and some news today.
Conseiller du ministère de la Culture et des Communications du Québec. CJMQ would like to thank the Ministère de la Culture et des Communications de Québec for its financial contributions.
CJMQ, 88.9 FM.
And you're listening to the On Air Show with Sven and Joel.
The On Air Show?
Does that sound good?
Sure. We are on air.
On the air with Sven and Joel.
That's right.
All right. I think I like that. I think it has a ring to it.
Okay.
And we're all excited and jazzed up because
we totally are. The
last guy that was in here, how do you pronounce his name again? Quetzal Angelos? And I'm sorry if I mispronounced your name, but man, this guy is awesome.
He's rocking. Yeah, I shook his hand, and for 1 second, I swear I had this flash. Like, I had this almost like a dream, and I could play. I was on stage, 40,000 people, and then, you know, like, the handshake was over and everything was back to normal, but it was absolutely
amazing.
It's like amazing.
That car advertisement where the guy touches the car and it's like everything flashes
and the car going. Yeah, that's what it was.
Oh yeah, that was totally amazing. That's phenomenal. And yeah, he's going to be playing tonight
at
Banding Hall.
So actually, like, I was like, okay, I'll shake his hand, I'll steal his power, but I'm sure it didn't work.
Well, we'll have to wait and see. We'll dig up the guitars after and see what happens.
Yeah, we'll see.
But in keeping with the whole mood of the last couple of songs he was playing, we decided to
electrify it
a little bit, and he will be playing some of the stuff at the concert tonight.